Okay, click on OK. So record session started. Why did you choose this testing? In market, we have number of courses like Java, Oracle, AP, .NET, PHP. We have number of courses. Why did you choose this testing? Is there any reason?
Well, in our in this country, testing got more priority, I think, in the market.
Why did you choose this testing? In market, we have number of courses like Oracle, SAP, .NET, PHP, number of courses available. Why did you choose this testing? Is there any proper reason?
Yeah, basically, I only recommend you have to do testing, yeah, because I saw lots of scope and all my friends are doing, they did the manual and they're working, so that's the reason I recommend you have to do the testing first.
So whenever you are facing the interview also, that time they may ask you like, why did you choose this testing? You should tell proper answer. So I will tell you, what is that answer? I will tell you. First point, scope of getting job is very, very high.
Okay.
First point, scope of getting job is very high.
Yeah, okay.
For example, right now I'm in Hyderabad. In Hyderabad, we have 3,000 companies. For example, we have 3,000 companies. Each and every software company may not maintain Java people, SAP people, .NET people, PHP people. But each and every software company, they want testers. Why? Because after developing the project or product, compulsory, they need to perform some testing. So that means each and every software company wants testers. That means the scope of getting job is very, very high. Not only in Hyderabad, wherever you go, if it is Bangalore or US or UK or Ireland or New Zealand or Australia, wherever you go, if it is software company, they need to develop some projects or products. After developing the project, compulsory we need to perform testing. So each and every software company wants testers, compulsory they will recruit test engineers. So that means the scope of getting job is very high.
Okay.
Second point, no need to depend upon other technologies. No need to depend upon other technologies. No need to depend upon other technologies. Without knowing anything, we can learn these testing tools nowadays. Nowadays, BA/BCom people, non-IT background people also, they are learning these testing tools and they are getting jobs. They are earning lakhs of rupees. That means it's very easy to learn, and after course completion, easily we can keep the experience and we can try for job. After getting job also, we can manage our job very easy. So that's the reason non-IT background people, IT background people, both people, they are learning these testing tools. It's very easy to learn, and after course completion, we can keep the experience. And if it is testing, there is no daily updations required. Once if you learn testing tools, you can settle in your life. That's the reason most of the people nowadays, they are choosing, they are encouraging only testing. So here is, no need to know anything. Without knowing anything, we can learn these testing tools. Nowadays, non-IT background people, mainly housewives, they are choosing this testing. It's very easy to learn, and daily updations not required. And it is a cool job, 9-to-6 job. Once if you get the job, if you get the job, you can settle in your life. That's the reason most of the people nowadays, they are choosing this testing. And at the same time, frankly, I'm saying not only in Hyderabad, not only in India, wherever you go. So in the area of software testing, heavy competition. We have heavy competition in the area of software testing. Why? Because non-IT background people, they are learning. IT background people also, they are learning. So that's the reason heavy competition only on testing. So you should do hard work. Then only we can get job nowadays. Right. And in the UK, so we can easily get the job. I know number of people, they did a course and after course completion, they got jobs in good companies with good package. So whenever you are comparing with India, so there is no heavy competition. Just if you do hard work, if you know subject, if you know something, some communication, if you know some confidence, you can get job. Right. Third point, testing remains forever.
Okay.
Testing remains forever. Why I'm saying testing remains forever? So if they were developers, if they want to develop any project, they will choose three technologies made up. One is Java, second one is PHP, third one is .NET. They will choose any of the technology. If they want to develop any project, compulsory they will choose any of the technology, or Java or PHP or .NET. Nowadays leading technology is Java. Leading technology is Java. Tomorrow Java will come. Tomorrow new tool, new software will come. That is Java. Or Day after tomorrow, another tool will come, another software will come, that is Mava. So, if it is any software, if it is anyone, if it is developed by any technology, compulsory we need to do testing. If it is developed by Java, or if it is developed in PHP, if it is developed in .NET, if it is developed in Java, or Kava, or Mava, whatever it is, compulsory we need to do testing. If it is developed by any technology, compulsory we need to do testing. So, that means testing remains forever. Testing remains forever. Compulsory we need to do testing. Why? Because after developing the project, compulsory based on the customer requirement, this project is working or not. Based on the customer requirements, it is satisfying all the customer requirements or not. We need to do testing. So that means testing remains forever.
Okay.
Fourth point, I want consistent life. I want consistent life. I want consistent life. That's the reason I'm choosing this testing. So, scope of getting job is very high. No need to depend upon other technologies. Testing remains forever. I want consistent life. That's the reason I'm choosing this testing. After this class completion, or whenever you are facing the interview also, somebody will ask you like, why madam, why did you choose this testing? You should tell only these four answers. Scope of getting job is very high. No need to depend upon other technologies. Testing remains forever. I want consistent life. That's the reason I'm choosing this testing. Next question. What exactly we required? What exactly we required to get a job? What we need? If you want to get a job, what we need? Tell me. Tell me, madam. What exactly we required to get a job?
Well, the education first.
Hmm. Only. Education means?
Well, we need to know what testing really means to get a job. We have to define it properly.
Hmm. That means that is testing subject. Okay, testing subject. Testing?
We need a
Okay, testing subject.
Right. I have testing subject. Can I get the job? What we need? Still what we need?
Okay. What we need?
Yeah, real-time experience skills. Real-time project skills.
No. You are working as a fresher. Okay, leave it. So, testing subject means everything. If it is real-time or fresher or anything. So, that is subject, or that is belongs to subject only. Second.
Well, I don't know then.
You should tell, madam. Compulsory, you should tell. What we need, if you want, if I want, or if you want, get a job, what we need? Sir Raj?
We need skill.
Sorry? Tell me, Raj. What we need?
For getting a job?
Mm.
Yeah, we need the right skill.
Skill means that is subject, total subject, that is belongs to total subject only. Subject, stuff, skills, experience, that is totally subject.
Okay.
If I have subject, can I get the job?
No.
What we need?
We need to satisfy the interviewer,
yeah.
What they're looking for.
Second one is communication.
Oh,
that is amazing.
That is, second one is communication. Communication also very, very important. So, nowadays number of people, they are suffering from only this one. So, sir, we should tell, so, whatever you know, so, you should explain like a very clear manner. So, that is called communication. So, I have subject and communication. Can I get the job?
No, you need more.
What we need still?
Qualification?
No, qualification is okay. Any graduate can do this course, madam. Any graduate. Minimum
okay.
Basic qualification. If you have basic qualification, then you can get job anywhere in the world.
So, commitment?
No.
Satisfying the interview.
We need one thing. If you have less subject, we can manage. If you have less communication, we can manage. We need one thing. What is that?
What is that?
What is that? That is confidence.
Confidence.
Yes.
Okay.
Confidence is very, very important. So, not only getting job, after getting job also we can face number of problematic situation. If you want to face each and every problematic situation, we need confidence. So, whenever you are facing the interview also, that time they are totally concentrating on person capability. She can do or not, he can do or not, they are concentrating. So, confidence is very, very important. Not only getting job, after getting job also we need confidence. Not only doing job or if you want to do business or if you want to do any other work, we need confidence. Confidence is very, very important. If you have less communication, we can manage. If you have less subject, we can manage. If you have less confidence, you can't get any job anywhere in the world. So compulsory, you should have confidence. Confidence is very, very important. You know, M-Tech people in Hyderabad or India, M-Tech completed people, still they are doing security job, and BA become people, they are doing software job in software companies. They are getting 2 to 3 lakhs rupees per month. That means is, so it is totally based on person confidence. Confidence is very, very important. So if you have confidence, you can get job anywhere in the world. If you don't have any confidence, you can't get any single job. That is final. So nowadays, totally they are concentrating on person capability. She can do or not, he can do or not, they are concentrating. So confidence is even more important. Okay, all right. Fourth point, dynamism. Dynamism means based on the situation we should change dynamically. Based on the situation we can change dynamically. So like for example, you don't have any idea about software company, you don't know anything. Finally you kept 4 years experience, finally you got job in MNC company like a level 5 company. So you are going to office, just you should behave like a dynamically, you should behave like a professional, like you know, you are keeping 4 years experience or 7 years experience. So you should behave like that, way of talk, way of work. So everything is different. Professional is professional, mass people is mass people. So you should behave like that. So dynamism also very, very important. So based on the situation, we should change dynamically. So if you need, if you have these four things, we can get job anywhere in the world. If you have these four things, we can get job anywhere in the world. Okay. Wherever you go, there are two types of companies. One is project-based companies. Second one is product-based companies. Wherever you go, okay. There are two types of companies. One is project-based company. Second one is product-based company. So what do you mean by project? What do you mean by product?
Project means the one that we do in for some particular things.
Mm-hmm.
And the product means the one we did it, like a
You should tell. You should talk something. A right or wrong, leave it. But you should talk something.
Okay. So this is like a course. Mm-hmm. And then product is the outcome of the course then.
Okay. There are, wherever you go, there are two types of companies. One is project-based company, other one is product-based company. So what do you mean by project? We will discuss now. So for example, Madam got job in UK with good package in good MNC company. So finally, your neighbors or colleagues or friends or relatives, they are asking some treat. So if you want to give the treat in your flat or home, so if you want to give the treat or party or something small, function, or if you want to do just like party or treat, you want to give the treat. So if you want to give the treat, you inquired in UK which is the best sweet house for sweets. Why? Because if it is small treat, so compulsory we should provide some sweets. So you inquired which is the best sweet house is for sweets. Why? Because there is no time to prepare the sweets. So compulsory we should prepare some sweets. You inquired in UK, okay, which is the best sweet house for sweets. Finally you got information, Akhil Reddy sweet house is famous for sweets, recently established in UK. So first of all, you will go to Akhil Reddy sweet house. First of all, you will go to Akhil Reddy sweet house and you will tell the requirements like, sir, we need 100 laddus, laddu. So okay. Each and every lad should be excise. Each and every lad should be excise. And each and every lead should be light brownish.
Okay.
Each and every lead should be light sugar. You are saying four requirements. Okay, you are saying four requirements. Based on your requirements, if they prepare laddu, that is called project. Project is something that is developed based on the particular customer requirements and used by that particular customer only. That is called project. Project is something that is developed based on the particular customer requirements and used by that particular customer only. That is called project. Project is something that is developed based on the particular customer requirements and used by that particular customer only. That is called project. Right. Based on your requirement, you are developing something. So that is called project. Whenever you are going to Akhil Reddy Sweet House, already they prepared some laddus like small size laddus, medium size laddus, big size laddus. This is called product. Product is something that is developed based on the company specification and used by multiple people. That is called product. Our laptop is a product. Our mobile phone is a product. Our toothpaste is a product. Our brush is a product. Our soap is a product. Our any mobile phone or desktop, laptop, pen, also all our products. Already they developed. If you are interested, you can buy and you can use it. So that is called product. Product is something that is developed based on the company specification and used by multiple people. That is called product. And used by multiple people. That is called product. Right. Now, based on this example, what do you mean by quality? And what do you mean by defect? Can you say anything? What do you mean by quality? What do you mean by defect?
Quality is like...
Yeah, tell me. What do you mean by quality?
Quality is the standard of the product. And the defect means the... Well, the wrong... Defect.
Nah. Okay.
Well, I know what that exactly means, but I can't like say.
Okay, quality means you are saying four requirements, madam. You want one some sweets like, you know, 100 laddus, each and every lad should be excise, each and every lad should be light sugar, and you are saying each and every lad should be light brownish. You are saying four requirements. Based on your requirement, if they prepare laddu, that is called project. Sorry, that is called quality. That is called quality. Quality is nothing but justification of the requirement. If you justify the all the customer requirements, that is called quality. Quality is nothing but justification of the particular customer requirements. Next, defect. Defect is nothing but deviation from the particular customer requirements. If it is any requirement deviated, that is called defect. Defect is nothing but deviation from the particular customer requirement. If it is any requirement deviated, you said four requirements. If it is anyone, it is not satisfied, that is called defect. That is called defect. Defect is nothing but deviation from the particular customer requirements. If it is any requirement deviated, that is called defect. That is called defect.
Defect.
All right. Next. ICICI Bank people want one project. ICICI Bank people want one project. For example, ICICI people want one software. They inquired which is the best software company for developing the software. Finally, they got information. Infosys is the best. Infosys is the one of the company. It is the best company in India. So, in UK also, it will be. I don't know what. So, Infosys is the best company. Finally, they got information. Infosys is the best. First of all, they will go to Infosys and they will tell the requirement. All the requirements they will tell to company people. So, the ICICI Bank people want software. They inquired which is the best software company for developing the software. Finally, they got information. Infosys is the best. So, first of all, they will go to Infosys and they will tell all the requirements very clearly. After telling the requirements, they will analyze. Based on the customer requirement, this project is possible or not. We can develop or not, they will analyze. After analyzing the requirements, they will give one estimation. Estimation means they are saying requirement, they want one software, that software they want to implement 150 branches. They are saying requirements. They want one software, that software they want to implement in 150 branches. So, based on the requirement, they will give one estimation. Estimation is it will take 3 months time and 3 crore rupees.
Okay.
3 months time and 3 crore rupees. After estimation, the customer, if they feel reasonable, if he feel reasonable, then they will write official agreement. They will write official agreement. This official agreement is called bidding the project. This official agreement is called bidding the project. Bidding the project. Bidding the project. So this is the bidding the project. In software company we are calling bidding the project, or we can say easily, simply we can say it is a signed off also. We can say signed off also. We can say signed off also. In software company we are calling official agreement. In our real life we will call official agreement. In software company they are calling bidding the project or signed off. Bidding the project or signed up. ICICI Bank people want software, they inquired which is the best software company for developing the software. Finally they got information, Infosys is the best. First of all they will go to Infosys, that's and right. They will tell the all the requirements. After telling the requirements they will give one estimation. So after estimation they will write official agreement. This official agreement we can call it is a bidding the project or signed up. After official agreement, each and every software company, they will conduct one meeting. That meeting name is kickoff meeting.
After the estimation.
After official agreement. After official agreement, each and every software company, they will conduct one meeting. That meeting name is kickoff meeting.
Okay.
Kickoff meeting is nothing but this is the first meeting or initial meeting conducted in the software company soon after the project is signed off. In this meeting, high level management people will be participate, like quality managers, team leads, quality leads will be participate in this meeting. That is kickoff meeting. Kickoff meeting is nothing but this is the first meeting or initial meeting conducted in the software company soon after the project is signed off. In this meeting, high level management people will be participate. Why they are conducting this meeting? They want to intimate the information to all the people. So and so Infosys people came to company and they gave requirements. Based on the requirements already we gave one estimation. So if it is any required, compulsory you should help me or you should cooperate with us, so then only we can able to complete that particular project. So that's the reason they are conducting one meeting. That meeting name is kickoff meeting.
Okay.
This is the first meeting or initial meeting conducted in the software company. In this meeting, high-level management people will be participate, like quality managers, team leads, quality leads will be participate. In this meeting, they will select one project manager for this particular project. They will select one project manager for this project. They will select one project manager for this project. They will select one project manager for this project. After selecting this project manager, you will prepare one mail and you will send it to CEO of software company. You will prepare one mail and you will send it to CEO of software company. Sir, this is Akhil Reddy. Yesterday we conducted kickoff meeting. I got selected as a project manager. Please give the permission to start this particular project. So he will prepare one mail and he will send it to CEO of software company. That is called, that note is called, that mail is called project initiation note or PIN, project initiation note. It is a note prepared by project manager and sent to CEO of software company in order to get the permission to start this particular project. After getting the project, we can start the project. After getting the permission, we can start the project. After getting the permission, we can start the project. This is called PIN. PIN means project initiation note. It is a note prepared by project manager and sent to CEO of software company in order to get the permission to start this particular project. After getting the permission, we can start the project.
Okay.
So, in the testing, first concept in testing, that is SDLC, software development life cycle. So, first concept in testing, that is SDLC, software development life cycle. Software development life cycle contains 6 phases. First one, initial phase, we will discuss later, but initial phase, analysis phase, design phase, coding phase, testing phase, delivery and maintenance phase. delivery and maintenance phase. Software development lifecycle contains software development lifecycle. This is the first concept in testing. First concept in testing, that is SDLC. SDLC contains 6 phases: initial phase, analysis phase, design phase, coding phase, testing phase, and delivery and maintenance phase. Delivery and maintenance phase. These are the 6 phases we will discuss tomorrow.
Now,
if you have any doubt, no, you can ask me now. Just interaction.